Joseph Evangelization Network. I'm your host for the next 3 minutes or so, Peter Karutz. We are at Catholic Men for Christ. I have to look at where I'm at. I've been doing it all day. It's live, it's noisy, but that's okay. You'll endure it. That's what live radio is all about, right?
Absolutely.
I was about to say hello by your first name, but now I know you're a deacon. So good afternoon, Deacon.
Good afternoon, Peter. How are you?
Good to see you. Tell me your name.
Deacon Tyler McClay with the Diocese of Jefferson City.
He told me Tyler, and I had to drag the deacon out of him. So you're here at the conference.
Right.
Have you been here before?
I have. It's a great conference.
Well, if you've been here before, why do you got to come again? Tell us, why do you got to come again?
You know, I come just to get, it's like a shot in the arm in the middle of the winter. You know, it's an opportunity to come and just spend some time listening to some great speakers and have a chance for confession and be with other men.
And you're a deacon. Why do you have to come? Haven't you all figured it out?
No. I mean, not by a long stretch. And this is what's great about this is an opportunity for us to kind of take in a little bit rather than sort of giving out in ministry all the time. So it's us just to rest
and
receive.
Isn't it great to be with so many, you know, I don't know what our numbers are at, but over 1,000 men for one purpose, to love God more and to make sure we are the men that God wants us to be.
Yeah, it's great. It's a great opportunity.
Single purpose we're moving forward with. But tell
Absolutely.
Me, what are you doing? And I know you're a deacon, but,
right.
you know, today deacons have a wide ministries. Are you in a parish? Are you, what are you doing, Deacon?
Well, I'm a deacon at a parish in
St.
Joseph Cathedral Parish in Jefferson City.
Oh,
that's the
are you
cathedral
really?
Parish, yeah, yeah. In the Diocese of Jefferson City. And but I also work for the Missouri Catholic Conference, so we do public policy for the church at the Capitol. So I'm essentially a lobbyist for the church. I try to promote church's teaching at the Capitol. I do a lot of work on pro-life, you know, criminal justice reform, trying to protect programming for the poor, that kind of thing.
We are blessed with a great legislature, I would suggest. I look at what's going on in some other states and it looks crazy. And what are we doing here? You know, when a woman is going to make a life and death decision, our legislature has said, maybe you ought to think about it a little bit. I mean, it seems to be countercultural almost. You're making an influence. I know we haven't done everything, but we're doing something, I think.
No, I think we've done a lot of great work in Missouri and in the pro-life area, you know, and trying to protect the unborn. So hopefully we'll do some more, you know, after the New York law that passed a couple of weeks ago.
Virginia passed.
Yeah, pretty troubling. So hopefully Missouri's going to turn that around here and be a witness to others.
So let me just get crazy for a second. I like Virginia's proposition. Right? They say right up until birth. And then some people are saying, well, maybe after birth. Well, you know, because if there isn't anything wrong with abortion, well, why not? Right? But when you hear these laws coming about, it shocks your humanity. All of a sudden, that rhetoric brings it home. I could kill a child who's about to be born? I mean, well, maybe the other side, the so-called pro-choice, maybe they're not being honest. I mean, you almost need that shock to bring us back to reality.
No, I think you're right. I think, you know, New York removed language in their statute that would have made it a crime to kill the unborn child in the womb. So if someone were to kill a woman that was pregnant in New York now, that it's only a single homicide, not a double homicide.
That's right.
And it's essentially saying the child in the womb is not a person at all.
That's right.
No personhood.
That's right.
And that's really, really troubling.
Yeah. And science has come along so far that it's almost non-credible to say this is not a person, a human being, someone with unique DNA, right?
Right, from the beginning of conception.
The woman may be carrying a child with a different blood type. The woman may be carrying a child that's a boy. It's not the same person. It's a different person. Well, thank you for your work. Thank you
You're
for
welcome.
Your work.
Thank you.
If you have some advice for our men out there who are thinking of coming to the conference, and maybe even those who said, I don't know what you're talking about. Why should I come to this conference? You're a deacon.
Yeah.
Why should us common men come to this conference?
Come so you can learn more about your faith. Come to be a better father, a better parent, a better spouse, and you know, really, the ultimate goal for all of us is to get to heaven. So come on to stay on the train to get to heaven. You know, that's our goal. Really, we're spent, you know, we are made for God. God is, you know, we are made to be in relation with Him. And that's what this is all about.
As Patrick Coffin used to say, go be a saint. What else is there?
Yeah, exactly. What
Deacon,
else is there?
Thank you so
Thanks,
much.
Peter.
And
Appreciate
thank
it.
You thank you for your ministry and your hard work.
No, you're welcome.
You're a blessing. I am Peter Karutz. This is St. Joseph Evangelization Network. We're live at the Catholic Men for Christ. Come next year and visit us online at sjen.tv, where you're going to see this interview, more interviews, and really find your heart filled with the love of Christ. God bless you all.